So welcome again in my tutorials, and this is the second part for the LF client, which is the required configuration for the AutoFS service. Now we need one package with the name same as AutoFS, yums space install space AutoFS space hyphen y. It is already installed in our system, so we don't need to install in it again. Now we will run. Now we will open its configuration file, which is vim space slash etc slash autofs auto dot master. In this we will give entry for the LDAP server home directory. For this you can run the command slash git and space passwd space slash LDAP user number. Here our home directory is rhome/rhome, which is on our server space, or you can use tab bar slash etc slash auto dot misc, which is the again different configuration for the AutoFS service. Now save it and come out from this service. Now configure LDAP auto.misc for LDAP for one user, or you can make it for the all users. Vim space slash etc slash auto.misc. Now go to last line with shift G. Now you can go in last line and enter LDAP user 30. I am using 30. And hyphen fs type is equal to nfs, because here our type is nfs. We are mounting our directory with nfs. If the nfs version is 3, then you can tell that nfs comma nfs var 3. Now here you can tell the directory instructor.example.com/:/rhome. You don't need to apply colon before the instructor slash rhome slash LDAP user 30, and remove the here. We can see that LDAP user 30 is in home directory slash rhome. Now we will restart our AutoFS service and check config AutoFS service. Now it is the second part. Now we will see how to configure LDAP client for all users. In previous we have saw how to configure LDAP for one user only. Vim space slash etc slash auto.misc. Go to insert mode and enter. You can command this line and enter the another line with the O. It will go in insert mode, and now you can apply asterisk for the all users and tab hyphen fs type is equal to nfs. Now you don't need to add colon here. Now it's example.com instructor.example.com colon slash rhome slash ldap, or here we will use s emerson sign and go outside from the configuration file. Now you have to restart your AutoFS service with service space AutoFS space restart. Here I am skipping this step, or you can see this step here, service space AutoFS space restart. It is a main step in this, because if you will not restart your AutoFS service, then it will not update. And check config autofs space hyphen y space on to enable it for the booting time. Thanks for your time, and subscribe us on youtube.com/careerandtricks for more updates in your email. Thanks.